Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Quite a while ago, I did a tutorial showing how to transform photos into the look of pencil drawings. Now, I'll show you how to streamline it and how you can quickly apply the effects to other photos. Before we begin, to get 20% off the newest versions of Photoshop and Lightroom, click the link in my video's description. Open an image you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. To check its size and resolution, go to Image and Image Size. This document is 963 pixels wide and 888 pixels high. Its resolution is 150 pixels per inch. Your image can be any size, but to ensure that the final result will look similar to mine, make its resolution 150 pixels per inch as well. Then, click OK. Click the icon at the upper right corner of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. This will allow us to modify our image non-destructively as well as replace it without having to redo all the effects. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Drag the saturation to minus 100. Click the thumbnail of the top photo to make it active and change its blend mode to color dodge. Then invert the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command I. At this point, most of your image should look white. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Slide the radius to an amount that makes your image look more like a pencil drawing than a photograph. Then, click OK. We're ready to give our image texture. First, if your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard or click this icon. Make the top adjustment layer active and click the new layer icon to make a new layer above it. We'll fill the empty layer with white, and since white is our background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Change its blend mode to Multiply. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Texture folder and click Texturizer. Make the texture sandstone, the scaling 100%, the relief 4, and the light from the top left. Then, click OK. To replace your image with a different photo, double-click on any smart object to open its source image. If you're working on version CC, go to File and Place Embedded. If you're working on an earlier version of Photoshop, I'll tell you what to do in a minute. Locate another image you'd like to use and click Place. Place Embedded automatically places the image onto your other document as a smart object. To resize it, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. Then, click the check mark at the top. To update the smart object, close its tab. When you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. The smart object instantly updated itself with the new photo. For earlier versions of Photoshop, go to File and Open. Find your image and click Open. Drag the new photo onto the tab of the smart object and without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the image and release. Open your Transform tool to reposition and resize it. As before, click the check mark and close the tab of the smart object. When you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. Open the tab of your pencil drawing. You'll instantly see that the smart object updated itself with your new photo. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.